Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Fresh Friday. I'm excited to be here with you again to talk about sweet potatoes. So in October, we did all of the squash, and sweet potato has a similar consistency to squash, but it definitely has its own flavor. And if you look up on Pinterest, you can find about 10 million different recipes for sweet potatoes. So it's a very popular vegetable. It's a healthier starch, and I'm really excited because we are prepping for holidays. It's almost Thanksgiving. Pretty soon, before we know it, it's gonna be Christmas. And the number one thing that I love is just cooking for the holidays. And I know a lot of people dread that. So that's why I'm here. And we're going to make three different sweet potato recipes today that can be sides, that can be main dishes, that will just help use local fresh products, but will help you prep for all of your holiday gatherings. So I'm really excited. I got some sweet potatoes at McGlasson Farms in Hebron, Kentucky. And it's really nice. It's a quaint little market stand that is along the Ohio River. So it's just on the border of Kentucky. And it was really beautiful. They had tomatoes in November, like beautiful, plump, juicy tomatoes. They had a number of peppers, a ton of squash, apples, and like I said, sweet potatoes. So they had a Japanese sweet potato, that is that purple one, it has like a white inside. They had a white sweet potato, and then they had your traditional orange ones. So that's what I decided to use. I wanted to accommodate the most amount of people, that if you can't make it out to a farmer's market, or you can't find any local sweet potatoes, that you will be able to go to your local like Kroger, Walmart, and find an orange sweet potato. So we're gonna be making sweet potato biscuits, and then we're also gonna be making a sweet potato mash that has a really nice mushroom gravy. It's very rich. It could kind of convince any meat eater to eat it. It's amazing. And then we're also going to be making a sweet potato casserole, but this is slightly different than your traditional. It doesn't have any marshmallows on it. It actually has like a southern pecan brown sugar, and it's amazing. It's basically dessert. So I'm excited. Let's get into it.
To start us off, we are going to make the sweet potato casserole. So I gave my sweet potatoes a nice wash and scrub, and while they're still wet, I'm gonna roll them in paper towels, pop them in the microwave, and they should cook for about 8 to 15 minutes, depending on size. You can use a fork to poke them, just make sure that it is soft all the way through. While that cooks, we're gonna get the topping together. So you're gonna mix your flour, brown sugar, chopped pecans, and your butter, and you are just looking to mix this so that you have a slightly crumbly texture. Once the potatoes are ready, take them out of the microwave. They're gonna be very hot. Try and let them cool before you cut into them, unless you're like me, and then scoop out the insides. Once the potato mixture has actually cooled off, you are going to add in your sugar, butter, 2 eggs, and then your vanilla extract. And once that is all good, you are going to use a hand mixer to mix it until it is smooth. Add the whipped mixture to a greased baking dish and then top with your delicious mixture. Pop it in the oven at 350 degrees for about 20 to 25 minutes and it will be golden perfection. To get us started on the sweet potato biscuits, I have my flour, baking powder, and salt here. And I'm going to take some cubed cold butter and put it in here. And I'm going to mix this with my hands. You can use a food processor, but the idea is you want to work fast without using your body heat to melt the butter. You want chunks of butter. So we're going to grind this in our hands until we get about a coarse meal consistency. Once that's ready, you're going to add in your sweet potato. This was cooked the exact same way as the casserole potatoes were, so we just popped them in the microwave for 8 to 15 minutes. And you're just using the inside for this. Once you get that to the consistency that mine looks like, mine's a little bit dry, so you're going to add in some milk. Definitely do little by little. And you don't want it wet, you just want it to be able to come together. You're gonna churn that out onto a floured surface and using a rolling pin, roll it to about 1/2 inch thick. You can use a biscuit cutter or like I did, just a lightly floured top of a cup. And you're gonna cut this until you get biscuit shapes. I would only recommend re-rolling out your dough about 3 times and then discard the rest just because you can get some pretty tough biscuits. But then you're gonna add it to a greased baking sheet and put it in the oven at 425 for about 10 minutes. You just wanna look at the tops and see that they're getting a little bit golden. And finally, our third recipe. So for the sweet potato mash, I'm actually gonna start with making the mushroom gravy. And you're just going to take a pound of sliced mushrooms. You can buy these pre-sliced at the store. I like to cut my own. And then you're going to mince up 2 cloves of garlic and chop 1 medium-sized onion. Once our vegetables are ready to go, we are going to melt butter in a deep saute pan. And once that's melted, we're going to add in our onions first. These have a lot of water, so we want them to exude some of that. Then throw in your mushrooms. These fungi are full of water as well, so we want all of that to come out, or at least for them to soften. Once you see this starting to soften, you're gonna throw in your garlic. If you put garlic in the beginning, like a lot of recipes tell you to do, it will burn because it's such small pieces and the oil content in it. So just be sure to follow that. We're gonna season this with a little bit of salt, pepper, and dried thyme. And then we are going to add in about a tablespoon of flour. Mix this in, make sure that cooks off just a little bit. And then we're gonna add in some tomato paste, stirring constantly. If you are using a pan that is not nonstick, so unlike me, you are going to want to deglaze your pan with either some white wine or some extra stock if you have it. I added the white wine in anyway for some extra flavor, and you want that to reduce a little bit, and then you're gonna add in some stock. I chose to keep this vegetarian, so I used vegetable stock, but you can use beef stock for extra flavor. Reduce this to a simmer and then let the sauce get to about half reduction and this will be ready to go. I added in about 2 tablespoons of heavy cream to this to give it a nice rich flavor as well. For the sweet potato mash, we are going to peel and cube some sweet potatoes, and I'm gonna melt some butter here and add our sweet potatoes into it. You are just looking for them to get a little bit glossy, more vibrant, start to soften a little bit, and then you're gonna add in 2 cups of your half and half and bring this slowly to a boil. Once that gets to a boil, you're going to add on your lid and reduce it to a simmer. Be sure to stir these frequently. You don't want them sticking. It should take about 20 minutes and you'll see that the sweet potato is starting to fall apart or crumble. That's a good sign. So you can use a potato masher like I started to do. And then I ended up using my handheld mixer to get a smoother finish on these. So here are our final products. So for the sweet potato casserole, the oven gave it a nice caramelization on top. It has a nice little crunch. This is perfect for any buffet or dessert that you are doing for the holiday season. Our biscuits also turned out really nicely. They have some nice layers, even though we didn't do an intensive biscuit process, which I greatly appreciate. And then for our mash, I made mine really creamy, and the addition of the mushroom gravy is just the cherry on top. It's so rich and luxurious. I really love it. I cannot wait to make it for my own family this holiday season. I hope you guys will give these recipes a try. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to support local and support McGlasson Farms in Hebron, Kentucky. Thanks, guys.